The kinship of God from the inner temples. Ample times, men slumbers from the reality that love is similar to inner happiness, oblivious to the fact that there's a silver lining that lies between eros and philos. Where agape is more like limbo. You will be a fool to offer the blue pill, because these poems live in us. And our duty is to awaken the sleeping beauty. To that girl who still suffers amnesia from an overdose, may your near-death experience remind her that you are still a nymph. That your knees bruise from scraping your father's floors. Look, time has passed you by for neglecting your childhood responsibilities. Because you were busy carrying empty buckets over your head, attempting to capture every teardrop from your mother's licking hooves. Dear little child, the clouds will one day gather over your storms and shower you with blessings upon blessings. They will see you when you can see them. Them, the departed spirits whose souls are stripped naked and torn from their ageless cosmic bodies. From a universe that is a timeless mind now existing in Teutonic age. Back to Nephilim, sat Odin the thoughtful god, as he lashed on the religion, like the king of Helim, who finally calls his pilgrims back home to the land of the deceased. A pagan kingdom for the deceased, what used to be a battlefield for brave men, now public hospital beds for boys who wet their pants in the struggle to perfect their last breath. Fallen heroes, consecrated with a kiss of death. Now every time they speak, they poison the mind of the self-oppressed, though the artist's mindset catches the poison upon the chalice. It still drops upon the lips of the starving barbarian whenever his vessel is full. Therefore, empty yourselves, refurnish your palace. Let every breath you take remind you that you are new. I mean, Hermes still bears a clear message on his forehead that reads, I quote, "If any creature weeps for the beloved, then he shall return to the ether. Otherwise, he must remain on earth," close quote, but not lawful. As she continues to weep, not the goddess of lost lovers, whose duty is to bring them close together in spite of any obstacle in the forever. So she begins to sing songs that are not in tune with Freya's harp. An amputated somnambulist, now a musician composing lullabies from symphonies orchestrated by supernovas in an attempt to sing herself back to sleep. A selfish god who dances to nobody's music. A feckless demon whose characters to mirror Jesus. A childish mother who fumbles upon words summoned for prayer. A humble elect of the universe whose duty is to be guardian to wise angels. Those who are wise enough to spare their wings for future flights. Like a boy who lost both his arms but still dreams beyond the heights of flying kites. Like a church whose roof is still leaking. My mother, a congregation whose forehead is sprinkled and touched by the hand of the Baptist. My family, a pillar of strength that has lost all its rigidness to the strong arm of the law. Now fellow men stands accused. These are men who wore holy robes to all, tight ropes around their necks to replace their ties. Men who carry briefcases that entailed their life sentences. Men who stood as both the victim and the suspect to the system. Groaners, these are your children. Take them home. These are all your children. Take them home.
Hello. Sedibe, thank you so much.